of genteel ethnic cleansing because about 250,000 English-speaking people have left in the last 15 years.
Montreal novelist Mordecai Richler has ridiculed the laws and Madame Baudouin and what he calls her tongue troopers.
Are they still, in effect, fighting a 250-year-old war?
To some extent, because, you know, on the license plates everywhere, it says, Je me souviens, I remember. And I think what you're supposed to, no one's quite sure what they're supposed to remember, but I think it's the battle on the plains of Abraham.
This sensitivity, this determination to maintain a French culture in North America was born of defeat. Here in 1759, on the plains of Abraham, on the heights of Quebec City, the British under General Wolfe defeated the French army under General Montcalm. It established, once and for all, a British North America, or at the very least, an English-speaking North America. And that was that. Except, of course, it wasn't.
One war ended, another had just begun.
Okay, no bullets, no guns, but it's laws, it's restrictions, it's language cops, it's harassment.
English professor Keith Henderson,
what's he got?
Is fighting a rearguard action against what he sees as a grand design.
It's driving people out, because North America is a mobile society. People say, I don't need this anymore. I mean, come on, I've got a life to lead, a business to run. What do I need to fight with language cops for? And they leave.
The prize in this war